Hi, my name's Marion Calmer and I'm a farmer from Western Illinois. I've been doing research for the last 35, 38 years, and we were studying surface applied P and K in some of my high fertility plots. The problem was that I'd spend $100 and maybe get $30, $40 worth of corn. And I'd spend $50 and get maybe $25 worth of soybeans. And so I just felt I wasn't getting a return on investment. And then somebody mentioned, well, maybe all the fertilizer's on top of the ground, it's stratified, and so the roots have depleted all the nutrients in the lower portion of the soil profile, but everything I bought is still at the top because it just isn't moving. So, as Lord Kelvin would say, I can't improve on things I don't measure or research. So I decided last fall that I was gonna go inch by inch and soil test and look at stratification. The probe that I use is M&M Supply. It's made out in Iowa. And the reason I use this probe is because it's got an open top, so I can get in here and pull these little soil cores 1 inch at a time. So first thing I'm gonna do is pull a soil probe here. And a little wet out today, but still able to get a good core. And then I lay it on the tailgate and then I open it up and let it sit right here. And that way it won't fall over on me. So the next thing I gotta do now is go in and cut it inch by inch. And take the top inch, and the two, and three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. And then I've got eight bags laid out here, 0 to 1. And so we grab that top piece and drop it in that bag. And here's 1 to 2, and 2 to 3, 3 to 4. This is 4 to 5. 5 to 6, 6 to 7, and 7 to 8. And they don't have to be perfect, but you get somewhere close. And so we're only dropping an inch in each bag, and you literally have to go around the truck and do this about 30 times in order to get enough soil in the bags to get an adequate sample. So the next thing I do then is I put these in my shop and I let them air dry for about 2 or 3 days. And then these little cubes get just real hard. And I want to help the lab get a good sample. And so then we take all those little cubes and put them into the NutriBullet. I got this from my significant other when she wasn't looking. And put them in here and set her down in there and grind them up, and then you can pour the powder back into the bag. So that way when the lab opens it, they've got a nice mixture in there of dry soil and they're ready to go. So just for the fun of it, these are my results, and we should be having them posted on our website, or you can holler at us, we can send you a copy. But sure enough, my assumptions were correct. Over the 16 years of consecutively surface applying, I have 50% of my nutrients are above the seed. They're in that top 1 to 2 inches. So they're basically not doing me any good at all. And the other thing is, because those levels are very, very, very high, they're maybe almost a little toxic to the roots, and maybe the roots don't want to grow into that. And then of course down here at the bottom, at the 8 inch level, then I've got nutrient deficiencies. And so where the roots are at, I don't have any nutrients. Where the nutrients are at, I don't have any roots. So basically I'm telling you that putting phosphorus potassium on the soil really didn't do me any good, and I need to put the phosphorus potassium in the soil or destratify, which comes with some kind of tillage, but I'm a no-tiller. So we're working on the solutions, and we'd like you to be part of our study, our nationwide study, and call in. I think we had quite a few people, Commodity Classic, grab some soil probes and go home and do this yourself. But I wanted to give you the, at least the protocol that I'm using at my farm that gave me the actual results that I was looking at, and that's what I wanted to see. So as always, if you have any questions, give me a holler on my cell phone, 309-368-1182, and hopefully you can identify at your farm whether or not you have a nutrient stratification problem. With that, thanks for watching the video and have a great day.